What's good, YouTube? NandyGrow94 here to bring you another episode of Elder Scrolls 3, Morrowind. In the last episode, you guys, well, we didn't fare off too well, but I'm having us rest for at least until there's daylight. But we met the Talvani agents, who we have to fight all three of them at the same time. So we have to go through here. And attack. Oh wait, not attack. Well, we can. We can literally talk to this guy up here who's got... who's basically guarding the cave entrance, which is up there. Unfortunately, there's only some... Wait a minute, I've got an idea. I've got an idea. I've got an idea. No, wrong thing. I'm gonna put on the Dark Brotherhood armor. And I'm gonna get rid of the Chitin armor. Because one, the Dark Brotherhood is a light armor, which would benefit us greatly. But we can also get some of this stuff out of our way. Oh, okay. Now I see what one's the, the weight stuff. I'm an idiot. There we go. We have all of that equipped right now, too. We're getting rid of the Chitin armor just so when we pick up that, dispose of that guy's corpse, we don't have to worry about anything. You know, we still haven't leveled up yet either, which is actually incredibly shocking in my opinion. Alright, anyway, let's just get straight through this. This wood elf here is going to attack us with arrows when we talk to him about the Talvani agents. I don't know you. What do you want? Ashlanders, which we learn about the Ashlanders later. In fact, an Ashlander is part of the Nerevarine prophecies. Void of Mamaka is apparently a volcano. Yeah, a volcanic ravine. Cool. Guild Guide. That's neat. Latest rumors. At first, it seems the fuss about the Nerevarine prophecy was just silly superstition. Then I learned that the Dunmer have been waiting for Lord Nerevar to come back for centuries. The Incarnate, they call it. Every few years, an Ashlander appears, and the tribes call him the Incarnate. Then the Temple goes out, hunts him down, and reveals him as a fake. Why does the Temple worry so much about it? That's a good question. Little advice. If you want to know about a place on Vardenfell, talk to a scout. And the scout I'd talk to is alone. You can find her at Orle's trade house in Sednaeen. She's traveled all over the island. Okay, thank you. Little secret. If someone attacks you first, you have the right to defend yourself. If someone doesn't attack you first, you're going to break the law if you attack him. Morrowind is the northernmost east province. Yep. Lore. 50% of Vardenfell's inhabitants are Dunmer, the other half are Redguard, Breton, Nord, Altmer, Dunmer, Bosmer, Imperial, Khajiit, Argonian, and Orc. Bosmer. We're small, sharp, and smart. We love wild creatures, wild beauty, and wildlife. Unlike our dual cousins, we're not very polite. but don't have to be, since we shoot straight and run like the wind. Trade. He's a scout. Okay, Stilt Strider. Basically, Stilt Strider is your way to fast travel without the fast travel activating.
Run now! No one can challenge me! You chose the wrong customer to mess with!
Dispose of the corpse and go to rest. The reason why I'm going back to rest instead of immediately going to fight the other Telvanni agents is, well, that one can be quite obvious. It's the fact that you have to fight three of them at once, and that is a no good. I'm gonna go to the bunkhouse to rest. I'm just glad there's a nearby resting place in this game. I wish that I could be able to somehow pull a distraction, but I doubt that. Rest until healed for 6 hours, which means it's 9 a.m. when I finish this. Good, 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 good. I just don't like there's fucking fog everywhere. I'm gonna check and see if I can pull something off here, though. Longbow. And equip them to myself as well. Okay, good. I'm gonna see if I can pop them off from the starting point they give me. Because if I can pull that off, maybe, just maybe, we can actually kill all three of the remaining Telvanni agents. Part of me actually wishes that I had kept the Nord a little longer before doing his side quest, but hey, it is what it is. So let's hope and pray that I can get through here. I'm gonna actually save the game as soon as my stamina hits up, and then that's when we're going to take on the Telvanni. Well, when we get through this door. Loading area. Save game. Because we don't want a repeat of the last mining incident. Cool, I just picked them all off one by one. A wooden staff, arrow. Pick up the arrow. Scroll of summoned skeleton. Cheap, restore health. Close. I don't need to dispose of their bodies. Iron Sartsword. One-handed, 20 pounds. Heavy armor, tower shield, common pants. Alvag's dead. Yep, he was one of them. She was also one of them. And then the other one's right down here. Well, I swear this was a Khajiit. Literally doing this right now just to make sure I have weapons and stuff. Steel staff, chafing, yep. And close. Was that all I was supposed to do? Find and kill the four Talvani agents? It should have said my stuff was updated. Okay. So now, I'll put this away so I can move around a little faster. That was actually easier than I expected it to. Especially the last one, so this episode's going to be called I'm So Dumb. Because hell, it didn't even show me at the fucking cave entrance, it just told me, hey, this is the path to the cave, take this path and you'll find it. You know what would be really cool is if they had like weather condition stuff where like a certain armor actually wound up being so light or whatever, it actually started getting your character sick and your character couldn't actually fight very well and had to adjust their fighting style to protect them while they're sick. I know that sounded like a random ramble, but I am trying to fill empty space of just me traveling. Because I don't want to edit these episodes specifically so that people just see the quest. No, I want them to see where they need to go as well. I know Caldera is the next turn. So I turn over here, and Caldera's up this way. I remember that. But it's always nice to double check and see your sign, see the signs and see which direction to go. Caldera's that way. And I have to report to Balmora anyway, so and I did this with a Dunmer, the guide tells you to do it with a Red Guard. Because a Red Guard has the ability, like, Adrenaline Rush or something. and it allows you to pretty much attack everything without having to worry about blocking. Also have plans to audition for Skywind later. It probably won't be today. My attempt at auditioning will probably be tomorrow, to be honest, while I'm off, and hopefully off period, after recording the next couple of episodes of Fire Emblem. This is episode 9, I believe. I'd like to report being attacked. You say you've been attacked by assassins? From your description, it sounds like the work of the Dark Brotherhood. I'm not sure who you angered, but stay away from me. I suppose this should officially be reported, although speak to Apellix Martius in Ebonheart about this matter, okay? He's recently arrived from Cyrodiil. You'll likely find him expecting the grounds at Ebonheart. Okay, thank you. Wait a minute. What's Ebonheart? And it won't let me know. Dark Brotherhood. Scum, all of them. If they're after you, friend, you better find yourself some help, or write a will. Or both. Guard. Fines and compensation. Yeah, I think I'm gonna get the overhaul mod later. Like, it'll probably be after episode 10, and I hope that it doesn't mess my load game up too much. Anyway, I'm gonna get back to Balmora before ending this episode. I mean, I know I'm already near the 20 minute mark I usually do, but I don't think any of you guys will complain about a longer Morrowind. Hell? There's a guard right outside here. That's a new one. Anytime now, what? Actually, I want to check something real quick. What's my... Ah, okay. So that explains that part. I was wondering why it was so easy to kill them. And it's because we've got a decently high marksman skill. Light armor, which we have enough light armor, and I'm gonna keep with the Dark Brotherhood armor for now. Alchemy, enchanting, and conjuration. Oh yeah, that's right. Because the next thing, once they tell me to go to the next city for the Fighters Guild, I'm going to join Balmora's Mages Guild before heading back and reporting to the Blades. Because you need to have, like, some sort of weird, what's the word I'm looking for? You guys know the word I'm looking for, I just can't figure it out right now. I still need to get a pop filter. Once I get the pop filter, I'll be able to actually properly audition for it, though. But yeah, I'm planning on auditioning for either Dunmer, Red Guard, or Imperial. And possibly all three. I mean, I doubt that my voice has that deep of a range, but you never know. You won't know until you actually do audition for it, though. And I want to get a pop filter that has its own stand or something that I can actually attach it to the Yeti. That way I don't get incredibly fucked. I really hope I'm following this path properly. I know it's like a lengthy path, but still. I want to finish this episode after turn. You know what? Fuck it. We'll extend this episode a little bit to, well... Oh yeah, that weird dog thing that scared the shit out of me a couple episodes back. I'm being dead serious, too. It scared the crap out of me. Wait a minute. Was that a... It's a me brush! Cool. Can I pick it? It's a Roo brush. It's a me brush. You know what? Fuck it. That's this episode's title. I'm so dumb. Roo brush. Me brush. Here's that bridge. Still, I don't think you need the overhaul mod. In fact, I think like the graphics is what makes it nostalgic for people who play this before, but I will get the overhaul mod eventually. Probably after episode 10, like I said. In fact, I need to look up the overhaul mod anyway. Just to see if it works. And I have the full game, too, so... Because that includes the DLCs. And yes, I will get Skyrim Special Edition so I can play Skywind when the full game comes out. Alright, let's go turn in this quest before ending the episode. Turn in the quest and... Actually, you know what? We'll extend this, because this is the last quest on the page after this one.
Do not waste my time.
I won't waste your time, orc. Balmora, Guild of Fighters. What can I do for you, Jeebish? Kamona Tong. The Kamona Tong is an old criminal syndicate here in Morrowind, and as everyone around here knows, there's a gang war between the Thieves Guild and the Kamona Tong. In Balmora, the Kamona Tong hangs out over at the corner club called the Council Club. Watch yourself if you go there. They're not very nice people. Okay.
Outlander, did you want something?
Yeah, yeah, yes, I know. I'm an outsider. But does that mean you're a Morrowind native? If so, why aren't you an elf? Wrong people.
Watch your step.
I'm an idiot because I keep forgetting the leader is upstairs.
Can you ask your question quickly? I must be going.
Today's your lucky day, so let's hear it.
East Thieves Guild, a wood elf. The Telvanni prefer to hire Nords and wood elves. When they can't get natives, I know nothing about him, but this is not a Thieves Guild job, so he has no protection. She's been expelled from the Fighters Guild. She stole from her guild steward. She's stupid, but she can fight. She joined the Thieves Guild when we kicked her out. But she's nobody important. This Calder of Mind Trouble is not a Thieves Guild job. Thieves Guild, local dark elf. She's known on Azura's coast. She could be trouble. But like I told you, this Calder is not a Thieves Guild. Orders. $400 gold. You got all four? Good. That'll make some people at Caldera Mining Company very happy. Here's 400 septums. The Caldera Mining Company pays well, and when you're ready for more orders, let me know. Return a code book that belongs to the client. Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what is it?
Get the fuck out of my way, bitch! Yeah, I was gonna say, we'll just extend this episode slightly. I know that the South Wall Corner Club is this way. So I'm not even worried about it in the slightest. Oh, I forgot. You don't have hops in this game like you have hops in Skyrim. Or Oblivion, for that matter. Oblivion, you even have jumps that are actually decent-looking jumps. In fact, they're the reason I've survived most of the fights in Skyrim when I play on a difficulty slightly different. Alright, now I need to find the South Wall Corner Club. I know it's near. Actually, it's probably back here. Yeah. Yeah. I believe I remember this. Yeah, South Wall Corner Club. I know where that was. I didn't even have to rack my brain. Oh, hey. Here's the lady we're looking for. I haven't seen you in Balmora before, have I? You have a question? Admire fail. Keep it up if you really want to make me mad, okay? Bribe. Well, that's thoughtful. I'll take it into consideration. Your manner is offensive, Dark Elf, I must. You're too kind. Take another 100. Now, bitch, give me your codebook. Yeah, I was told you have to get her disposition to above 60. You know about the codebook? I don't want any trouble with you, so just take it. Just don't tell anyone I gave it to you.
Hail, Dunmer. Do you need something?
Thank you! Somebody who's not calling me a fucking outlander. Alright, I'm gonna finish this Fighter's Guild job. And end the episode, and in the next episode, we'll begin with either seeing if Caius Cascades. Well, actually, we're gonna get promoted first. Most likely. And we're gonna see if Caius needs anything. Because we are Blades, we should be we're a novice Blade at the moment, but that's subject to change. I'm literally just waiting on them to tell me to go to a different fighter's guild to advance.
Yes, what is it?
Because I know there's the possibility of you becoming... Thank you. Yes. $50. Good. Journal has been updated. Advancement. Your devotion to the Fighters Guild is not in question, but you still require more experience. Redouble your training and practice your skills to become Jeebus the Journeyman. Okay. Do you have any more orders for me? Okay. Debt money. Suran. And you'll give me 100? Cool.
No worries. I won't hurt you.
Anyway, that does it for this episode of The Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind. If you enjoyed today's episode, please leave a like down below, comment for more, and as always, have a wonderful day.